go. There's the shell. Some carbon one, Nautilus. Working on the shell part right at the moment. Already done these sections right in here to get them curved. This one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one are flat at the top. These have radiuses. These are flat also. Won't be carving on these yet until I lower the section of the sand dollar here. As you can see, I still have to remove this whole section to give it the depth, pulling it forward. But right now I'm just going to show how I do these. These were cut first with just a regular carving knife to get the rays, then a V-gouge was run down to open them up, give them some more definition. Down to the section where I need to round over the tops. So what I'm doing is using this very subtle round curved gouge, but I turned it upside down. And then all I'm going to do is go down in here and remove the high points. You got to think looking down the edge of the curve you're creating. There's an apex, and what you want to do is remove that apex point. Now you can do this possibly with a Dremel Fordham, but keeping these crisp lines with a power tool is very difficult to achieve. Can be done, very difficult. I find it a lot easier to just do it with the gouge. And nice crisp lines. You have to remember when you're doing this type of work, you're not removing a lot of material. I think it's a big issue with a lot of people that start carving. They want to get in there and they just want to see chips coming off. And there is types of carving where you can get that, have that, but this is not that type of carving. This is, here you just want to get the effect of the look you're going for and actually remove as little of the material as possible. So what I'm doing here now is I'm also going down into that V groove a little deeper each cut. I'm going to go back the other way. You can see that that's all I'm taking off each time, just like little slivers like that. That's all you're going to remove. If you're in a hurry, this kind of project is not for you. This does not go fast. It's a tedious, slow process. And we're going to go back and forth, removing each side. There. So once I get it, you can see this is a has been completely smoothed, and this these ones over here, these are kind of in the rough stage. Once I feel that I get enough curve going on before my gouge starts to dig in like it just did there on the other side. So that means I gotta come back over here and remove that. I also use jewelry files when I'm doing this type of stuff. So now that I have it established, I run the jewelry file down in there and give it a final smoothing, keep moving the file in the shape of the piece that you're doing. Keeping the crispness of the lines and the curve all at the same time. And that, see right there, you can see where the gouge made a line there, so I still have to remove some of that. You see I've rounded off the top of these. I just take the file and break this edge. And you can do this again with a power tool if you think you're that good without destroying the rest of the project. But for me, the little bit of material you're removing here, it's not even worth using a power tool. Also find this relaxing. So this is for me, it's a quiet evening, afternoon, whatever it is when I'm working, to create my stuff without the noise of a tool running. I just sit in my easy chair here, usually have some music going. Right now because of the video. So this is just the beginning stage of getting this done. I still will have to go back moving the entire project and fine-tune a lot of these things that I've missed. With my files, my sandpaper, my gouges. But to keep these fine details here coming down like this, very difficult to do this with a power tool and keep these lines that smooth and that crisp without slipping. Because once you slip with the Dremel and the power tool, the cutter will remove all that right in there, and there's no, you know, there's no going back. You're not putting it back on. So that's how I make these rays on these shells. I'm probably going to run another video eventually here and show you how I do the sand dollar and the starfish. May do another one on a little bit more of the shell here, depending on how the response is on the video. Thanks for watching.